Hello everyone, welcome back to the TOC lectures. Today we are going to start a new topic called conversion of a regular expression into NFA. So today we are going to see about how to convert a given regular expression into the non-deterministic finite automata. So we will start the lecture. So in the beginning of this lecture, we will see what are the requirements that we need to have before constructing an NFA. So we should have some basic knowledge about how we can construct an NFA for a given regular expression. So please watch carefully the following procedure or the steps. So for the given regular expression R star, how you can construct a finite automata is, you all know that it will accept a zero or more than that symbols it will accept. So how you need to construct this? This is the equivalent finite automata for the expression. That is, it can accept 0, null. It can accept straight away, it can accept. Or it can accept a single R. Or 2, 3, 4, like that. It can go on. So this is the equivalent finite automata for the given regular expression. Similarly, we can construct for R plus also. That is, it has to accept a single R. After that, it can accept any number of R. That is what here the plus denotes. That is positive closure. It has to accept a single alphabet or a symbol, and then it can accept any number of alphabets or the symbols. So we have an initial state, and then we have R, and then we have like this. That is, it has to mandatorily accept a single R. It should accept a single alphabet or a single character or a single symbol, and then it can accept any number of characters or symbols. So this is the equivalent finite automata representation for R plus. Similarly, for R1 plus R2, that is what this is. This plus symbol denotes R. That is, it can accept either R1 or it can accept either R2. So how to construct this regular expression into a finite automata is, for this we need lambda moves or epsilon transition. Without that, we cannot construct. So this is the initial state. So this is the initial state, this is the final state. It can have either R1 or R2. So the empty transitions are represented by epsilon or lambda. You can denote in either ways. That is, this RE denotes what? It can accept either R1 or R2, and it will go to the final state. The next last one is concatenation. R1 into R2. How we are going to represent R1 into R2? Here we are going to take the two REs together. We are going to accept R1 and R2, and then only we will go to the final state. Here we cannot ignore R1 or R2. We can accept R1 and R2 together only. So how we can construct this? R1, we have R1, epsilon, R2, epsilon. That is, Here also we are having empty transitions. Okay, empty transitions are nothing but empty moves. R1 we are having, R2 we are having. We can concatenate R1 and R2 together and then only we can reach the final state. So this is the equivalent finite automata representation for R1 and R2. So we have covered basic REs and their equivalent finite automata representation. One more is there, I will cover that also. You can denote R1/R2 is equivalent to R1+R2. Both are same. You can denote in either way. You can construct like this also, like this also. We will go with this representation here afterwards. So now we will take the last expression. So how to construct for this one? So basically we have to take like this. So we are having R1 or R2 whole star, that is R1 and R2 can appear either 0 number of time or 1 or 2 or more. So how to connect? So these are nothing but empty moves. Here we are having R1 or R2. So here we can straight away go here. Okay, that is we can go without having R1 and R2 straight away to the final state. That is the first possibility, which represents greater than or equal to 0 0. Okay, or else what we can have? We can have a repeated call. That is, we can have R1 and R2 one time, or R1 or R2 two times, so on up to n. So this is the equivalent a finite automata representation for this RE. So we have covered some basic representations for the given REs. In the next part we will take some problems, some REs we will take, and then we will draw the equivalent finite automata. So in this lecture we have covered some basic RE representations and their equivalent finite automata representation. So you have to keep in your mind the following symbols, that is R+, you have to keep R*, R1 R2, R1 R2, R1/R2 whole star. If you are able to draw the finite automata representation for these 5 REs, then you can construct any RE and their equivalent finite automata. These are the building blocks. You need to have a clear idea about how to construct a finite automata representation for these 5. Then you can do any problem. So we have covered what the equivalent finite automata representation for a given regular expression. In the next lecture, I will give you a simple REs and their equivalent NFA representations. Thanks for watching.